Hey guys, happy new year. Hi and welcome to my channel. My name is Amber and I hope you guys had a great Christmas or a great holiday and a great New Year's. Today's video is a channel goal, reading goal, and January TBR all wrapped in one. So let's get into it. So my theme for today is I'm bringing mom on Christmas Day. All I'm missing is my tea and my house coat. That's what I feel like. My hair is unruly, so it's going in a scarf. And I just really love my silk pajamas, so why not film them? I didn't sleep any last night, by the way. But for starters, we're going to start with my channel goals. So, for my channel goals this year, I really just want to post at least once or twice a week. And then I want to branch out with doing reviews. I really enjoyed when I was doing, if you haven't seen my last video, where I did a review type vlog thing for Black Widows by Kate Quinn. I will leave it in the cards and link down below if you haven't seen it yet. And I really like that type of vlog. Or I'm gonna try and like actually sit down and do an actual review. But I just wanna say this, that I'm only gonna be critically reviewing ARCs. Other books that I'm reading will just get the normal, like, I like this. This could have been different. This could have been tweaked better. That stuff like that. I think ARCs are just gonna be the only ones that are gonna get that full on. I also want to, like I mentioned, I want to do more vlogs. I want to add more, like, my personality to the channel. Like, I want to add what music I like, what shows I'm watching, stuff like that. Those would probably be in my wrap-ups or, like, my monthly favorites. So, we don't know. I don't know. I incorporate some type of way. Okay, my reading goals. I think that was all for my channel goals. I didn't really have many. For my reading goals, though, I want to read more physical books that I own. I want to read less ARCs and new releases. I want to stop doing reviews, like critically reviewing books, because that is where it's like making me not be in love with reading as I want to, because all I read is new releases and ARCs, and then review them on like Goodreads or Instagram. And it started to become a chore. I know that a lot of people like do this for the ARCs, but I've been doing ARC stuff since I started in 2016. So like I'm over it at this point. So when I'm done with the ARCs that I have, I'm not gonna do as many ARCs. I'm not requesting. So if I get sent ARCs, I just better be interested in them. But I really don't wanna do the whole ARC thing anymore. Let's see, any other reading goals? I don't have a number, like a Goodreads challenge goal. I think I stopped doing that 2019 or 2020. I don't know. One of them years is when I actually stopped doing that, because it stresses me out. I don't have time to be stressed. I'm already stressed enough. I don't need the extra stress, okay? Okay. And I want to get more into adult fantasy. I do have, once we get into my January TBR, I do have one book that is an adult fantasy that sounds really good, and I really hope I like it, because last year I tried to get into adult fantasy. I read about one book here or there and like didn't really understand it after I read it, so I'm gonna try. And then like other random goals I have is just to make more bookish friends, show my personality more, because I feel like y'all don't really know me, and use my blog more, which I'll leave linked down below. I only have one post, not one post, but it has one newer post from last year, so I need to get on using that. Okay. Oh, and I also want to like post consistently on Instagram. But that is it. That is all the goals that I have. So that was all the reading channel goals that I have for this year. Now we're gonna move on into my January TBR. So yeah, let's get right on to it. So the first book on the list is James Baldwin's Jean Giovanni's Room. This is James Baldwin's third book. And this follows, it says, set in 1950s Paris of American, it dwells into the mystery of loving and creates a moving, highly controversial story of death and passion that reveals the unspoken complexities of the human heart. So it doesn't have like a main character name. I guess it just follows somebody in Paris and they find themselves and they fall in love, and it sounds really good. I have read James Baldwin before, so I'm excited to read this. This is pretty short. It's 169 pages. So this, I'm excited to read this, and this is going to be my upcoming read for the week. So the next book is Native Son by Richard Wright. This follows Bigger Thomas, and in the 1930s, he goes in a downward spiral and he ends up killing a white woman. So it's set in Chicago, and it talks about poverty and hopelessness experienced by people in inner cities and what it means to be black in America. I'm excited to read this one and watch the movie. And that's it. That's all I know about this. So this next one, I'm honestly terrified to read it because last year I read Kristen Hannah's The Great Alone. That book left me heartbroken, left me in tears. It became one of my faves last year. So I hear that The Nightingale, which is set in like a World War II setting and it follows two sisters, is going to leave you heartbroken. This is a thick book. I'm not trying to be emotional. I'm already an emotional person. I don't have time for tears. I actually do have time for tears, but I don't want to cry. So I don't know. I think I may leave this like the end of the month because it's a bigger one and these other ones are kind of short. But I also have two other books by Kristen Hannah that I need to read this year, which will be read. But like, so the next one is the adult fantasy that I was talking about at the beginning of the video, and this is The Rune of Kings by Jen Lyons. I've seen this book on Erin's page, Booked and Busy, and she is so into adult fantasy. She's the reason why I need to actually try. But I seen this on her page one day. She was like recommending fantasies, and it's about a dude who's like a, you know what, let me just go find the synopsis. So it says Kyren grew up in the slums of Cure. He was a thief and a minstrel's son, raised on tales of long lost princesses, a magnificent quest. When he is claimed against his will as the missing son of a treasonous prince, Kyren finds himself at the mercy of his new family's ruthless power plays and political ambitions. And then he learns that life ain't what he was taught. So that sounds interesting. I was going to try and get this physically, but I can't spend all my money on books. And then this last book, I'm so freaking excited for. So, I wasn't going to plan on rereading the series this year. Or was I? I don't know. But I had just reread A Court of Thorns and Roses last year. Loved it. Like, I reread A Court of Thorns and Roses, A Court of Mist and Fury multiple times. But I haven't reread A Court of Rings and Ruin. That became my favorite book. One of my favorites last year. Oh, so I was like, I'm gonna reread Throne of Glass for the 500th time. And it's not really the 500th time because I've only read Throne of Glass and Crown of Midnight 500 times because I would never finish the series. To clarify, I read the series fully last year, so I'm excited to read it again if I'm not making sense. Now, I'm gonna have all the books because as a Christmas present, late Christmas present to myself, I bought all the books I don't own. So I just have Assassin's Blade as an ebook, but it's coming in the mail. Books I don't own is the Assassin's Blade, Air of Fire, Queen of Shadows, Tyra Dawn, Empire Storms. And y'all, I'm so excited. I do know there is a Throne of Glass read along this year, so I will leave the links in the channels down below. And that is all my TBR this month. I've already read one book off my TBR, so it's not going to get out of here. And yeah, I hope you guys have a great month. If you don't see my face again, but I'm